Yeah, so good morning everyone. Let's start with morning commentary. As we see the daily chart of Nifty, one thing which is important, it was trying to go higher than the important level of 10,370 and also went almost to 10,400 levels. Now, all I'm trying to understand whether it can reach at least to the highs of 10,500 or so or not. So there will be a huge amount of resistance because of the Moribazu which has been formed prior over here. Okay, so even though it is trying to go above the level of 10,370 mark, it has to undergo a huge upside in order to fill this complete red candle, plus it needs to be residing above 10,470 or 10,500 to start a new upward trajectory. So today we'll try to understand as to what can happen on the upside. So downside we are pretty much clear. The moment lowest downside now I see for this entire rally or Nifty is 9,750. So that will be like a breaching mark and it cannot go below that. Second levels which are important is around this 10,100 mark where a bounce back took place. So now I particularly see 10,100 as an important point for Nifty retracement if any correction comes by. So going ahead, as we see over here, gap up, it did retest, and again when the correction came by in Nifty, it again tested 10,100. So all said and done, we need to basically understand if there is any kind of correction. There is a small gap around 10,250 and 10,100 can become a good support zones for Nifty. If a bigger correction needs to arise, it will be below 10,120, but it will reside roughly around 10,000 or 9,960 mark. So there is no huge downside as such on Nifty, but a small falls cannot be ruled out. And if we see over here the kind of U formation which is forming, okay, like a rounded top, we can basically see a small downside in Nifty trying to reach to the same gap level of 10,250 mark. Okay, and then it might bounce back either from level 1, which is 10,250, or level 2, which is 10,120 mark. So these are two important milestones now on the smaller time frame, but on the longer time frame, I do not rule out Nifty breaching the level of 10,120, and if it breaches, there is an easy chance of 9,960 to 9,800. But 9,700 will not be breached. So that is the lower end of Nifty. Why I'm trying to be more bullish on 9,700? Because multiple times it has formed a quick selling ground and it has retraced back. So the last rally which I saw was also from 9,700 on the weekly chart. So I hold 9,700 as a very important milestone, you can say, for Nifty on the downside. So understanding the downside, there are chances where on the weekly chart, what I see, if it does not reach to these levels of 10,450, 10,500, there are chances where it can reach at least to 10,100 to 10,000 zone. So a quick correction of around 300 to 400 points, that is 4 to 5%, is always there on the cards. Okay, so these levels can easily be used to make different bear ratios as we progress in the next expiry. Not right now, but maybe later. So more so, I'm trying to just understand on the higher side, there is a bigger resistance which is there. So it will require another push, let's say Gujarat state election or something like that, or maybe some other global event for a trigger of upside. But more or less, it will remain a range bound session till the election. But on the downside, if election does not pan out the way it should be, right? So there are two mishaps which are possible. So considering three things together for the next month, first is the RBI meeting. So RBI is going to do nothing. Inflation was higher. So Bank Nifty will remain weak. So number one, Bank Nifty remaining weak, it can bring Nifty back to the level of level zone of gap up around this 10,050 mark. That is, RBI meeting does not give any kind of rate cut. Second point would be if, say, a state election of Gujarat doesn't go as per the plan of action, then a downfall from these levels can reach to 10,120 and straight away to 9,960 mark. So this cannot be ruled out. And the third point, which we cannot, which we do, we are yet not placing it on Nifty, which is the oil rate. So if oil rate goes higher in the month of December, and normally we have always seen oil rates going higher in December because of the winter session kicking in, okay, in US and stuff. So, and if, and there is low liquidity or low volumes in December, you might find oil going higher. So I am seeing three things. The first level, 10,250, I can call this as RBI level. 10,120 or from any of these higher levels, 10,120 or 10,100, the state election level, and combined with the oil rally, it can bring them down to 9,950. Now, I'm not trying to be very bearish, but we need to understand if things do not go the way we want, there can be a downside which is easily likely. And the lower base which I am forming for my downside is 9,750. Okay, so that's on the downside. Now let's see on the upside. As we clearly said, so RBI cannot push the Nifty higher, so that is ruled out. Second is only the state election turning out in our favor. So only thing which can push Nifty higher is now the result of state election. So if it turns out to be good in our favor, then obviously Nifty will go higher and it can reach 10,500 mark. Now all we need to important one need to know if things go upside. So downside we have understood three events and where Nifty can come. Let's understand on the upside where Nifty can go. So I'm just trying to put some pivot levels, standard pivots, to understand, to get a view as to where Nifty can find some amount of resistances. So if I see for the month of November right now, the resistance is around 10,550 mark. Okay, so the two resistance point, 10,550 and 10,750. So two resistance on the higher levels, if I have to see, are 10,550 and 10,750. So if I assume that state election goes your way and it reaches to all time high, it might find resistance around 10,550. So that is one of the key important resistance level, I can say, which we need to keep in mind. So 10,550 or 10,600 can be a good resistance zone. Now second, if we convert this chart from, let's say, daily to weekly, just to understand on higher time frame where we can find resistance. So the higher time frame resistance is very, very far, that is 11,300, right? So that can be ruled out. So we are not near anywhere closer to the weekly pivots. So that's fine. But on the daily pivot, now I have two levels. One is your 10,550 mark, and the second one is your 10,750 mark, right? So then these two levels now become a good resistance ground for Nifty on the upside. And if it has to form a good upside after the rally, then likeliness of 10,700 is also possible. Now what I see over here, prior to the election, going into the election, if there is a correction, that will be a good sign for the market, because if it corrects, the good part is if it corrects, it will have a good ground to cover, and then it can go and settle in our resistance zone of 10,550 or 10,750 mark. So we are now pretty much clear on the downside as well as on the upside. So the upside will also be capped. It cannot be like one-way rally the way 2014 rally had come. But we need to also understand when this rally will arise. So let's say on the 15th of December, it can bring Nifty high to 10,750 mark. But after that, if oil rises along with this rally, a huge correction is also possible in the month of December. Okay, so a correction can come now because of RBI, because of state election, and the second is the oil rally, right? So all three can bring Nifty down from this point itself, 10,370. But let's say things do not become so worse, if Nifty goes higher to 10,500, 540 or 700 mark, you need to understand at the end of December, after the election, everything is done or results are out, if oil will rally, you can find a downward move in Nifty, bringing it back from these higher level of 10,600 to 10,700 back to these levels of 10,200, right? Because if I assume now, or I understand now, so let's put some annotation just to get a feel as to what can happen. So the first thing that I'm trying to understand is the move which will go downwards. Okay. So one is it can come to these levels of 10,250. And the reason why it can come to 10,250 is because RBI might not increase the rates and stuff like that. Right. So let's put your RBI will not increase or something like that. And then I go ahead and I see from here onwards, there might be a rally on the upside to, let's say, 10,700 or so, because the Gujarat election turns out in our favor. Right. So one way rally will take place by 20th of December or so. And I am assuming after this, if the oil rally kicks in at the end of December expiry, you can find it back coming to these levels. Right. So the correction can be the equal amount where the rise will happen prior to the election. Okay. So the upside from these level of 10,250, it can go to 10,750. That is around 500 points rally, which is more than enough. And after that, it will not just come back or retrace only half of that rally, that is 250 points. It might breach all the levels and come back from where it started. So 10,250 and 10,100 can be the point where it can come back all the way from these higher levels. So keep that in mind. So euphoria will be there on the upside because everyone would be cheering the political move, but you might get a good downside because of the oil as well. So this is where I'm trying to be a little cautious, and I'm trying to understand if things go upwards where it can reach and things go downwards, what we need to be prepared for. So expiry week generally tends to be more volatile, it doesn't seem like. And when I see Nifty, nothing is happening. It is trying to reach a little lower target and not go higher than 10,400 mark. And when I see Bank Nifty also, it is trying to remain range bound. Our major support level is 25,690, and that is where it has also formed a good green candle on the upside. So even Bank Nifty trying to remain in the range bound mode, and nothing big or special might be there for this expiry. Seeing after the move of Bank Nifty from 25,700 to 25,900 prior to the expiry suggests that there is more upside in Bank Nifty, especially coming out from ICICI Axis Bank trying to make Bank Nifty go higher. Right, so it might not come down. A good correction might not be seen now, and it might reside about 25,700 mark for the expiry. Right, so that's more or less for Nifty and Bank Nifty. Let's see for today's day, is there any good stocks that we can look out or understand the basic structure? Nothing big has happened, so big changes, gainers and losers might not be there. What I just see over here is Dr. Reddy from the pharma is trying to inch higher, so that is one place. Second, cement, which was corrected a lot back of the news, is now gaining some grounds. And then you have L&T and Tata Motors just bouncing from the lows, right? But all I can understand, I think Dr. Reddy showing a move of 1% might be something on the chart. So we can look out Dr. Reddy and Ultratech, which might be forming a reversal pattern. The loser side, if I see, it is Axis Bank on the top. So till now, Axis Bank has been going and making new highs, and now it shows some kind of profit booking. Apart from that, BPCL is now a little weak. So there is no other OMCs, but prior to that, if I remember correctly, it was IOC, HP, BP, all were correcting. And even on the commodity side, Vedanta, Indalco, all of them are correcting too. Okay, so the oil marketing companies and the Asian Paint, and then you have these commodity guys are all in the correction mode. So that was pretty much seen prior as well. Let's go and see some of the stocks. So if I look at Ultratech over here, it clearly signifies a good up move on Ultratech. What I see over here from the highs which were made during the result, it was not breached, selling took place, and then it made multiple highs, and this gap down happened because of the judgment which was passed. And then if you see the kind of reversal Ultratech has given, which might bring him again back to this 4350 level where the selling took place. So today itself, it can go to 4350 levels. The good stocks, if they correct, they will find these kind of reversals. And it is a very happy ground to trade these kind of reversals because it will go in your favor. So Ultratech is one of the good stocks where the results were also decent and good. And you can find good reversals, and especially which you can see over here. Ultratech, now let's see Dr. Reddy, which has shown some kind of move right in the morning itself. I see Dr. Reddy also being very strong, reason being after the pull-up which took place, selling happened, and multiple times support has taken place around these levels. So around 2275 levels, Dr. Reddy seems very strong, and what I see today is kind of reversal formation which is taking place might bring Dr. Reddy to 2365 or 2400 kind of mark. So reversal is seen on Dr. Reddy as well, and even Ultratech. Let's see LNT, where the construction pack is there. LNT, I still remember there was a gap which was formed around this 1210 mark. So LNT is remaining range bound. I am not interested to buy LNT. It's better we buy LNT prior to the result, or if Nifty corrects and LNT brings itself below this gap of 1200 or so, it can find a quick reversal from the lower levels, right? So we will wait and watch for LNT and not just go out and buy. All we can see, LNT after forming the gap up is now trying to remain range bound above the level of 1210. Looking at some of the bank like ICICI Bank, now what I need to understand from ICICI Bank, the expiries are set in. So after this huge correction and the bounce back which had happened, clearly shows that some people who are stuck in the rally at the downside are trying to now get out of the train. And if you see, this was the high which was made by ICICI. Now what I see over here, after the high which was made, a gap was filled and multiple highs were formed, right? So which clearly shows, again, ICICI can come back to the levels of 320, but upside might be limited now in ICICI. So that is one thing which is pretty much clear from the chart. Axis Bank, if we try to target, which is also inching higher the way ICICI is. So after the big move right from this 450 becoming 550, in this entire expiry, so it was the most volatile expiry. If you see, the result was worse, it came down, people shorted, they were stuck, and then it went up, right? So it might take some time for Axis Bank also to crack down, but till now it will remain range bound. If we can find any kind of gap up, gap down, and similar levels forming, we can sell even Axis Bank, but not right now. The important level for Axis Bank is around this 534 mark, because this is where the gap up has happened. So after this point, gap up has happened and multiple lows has been formed, right? So 535 mark becomes very important for Axis Bank. Let's take one more bank, RBL Bank. The results were fantastic for RBL Bank, and what do we see over here? After undergoing a fall, okay, it is trying to reach to this 500 mark, not even reached there. After a quick selling took place, it finds some kind of reversal on the upside. Now what I see over here, even which is very much insightful, if you see, there was a strong selling which took place, brought RBL back to 506 levels. After that, there was a strong gap up which took place over here of 3 to 4 rupees, and it basically zoomed higher to 525, making the high, and the selling took place, showing that there are big seller on the upside. Fine. So the chart till now basically seems that there is a good selling point at 525 levels and it might go down. But what we see the next day, there was a small green candle which was formed, putting the entire argument of selling and the pressure of selling currently out of the window. And following that, we see after the green candle, a good base, good body green candle has been formed from 516 to 520, right? And today morning, it tries to retrace back a bit and then inch higher. So 530 and 535 kind of range for RBL is normal and it can be attained in this expiry itself. But I would rather buy when these kind of setups basically form at the lower end. So it is always good to take stocks which correct, good stocks which corrects, and then we find these kind of reversals and it always goes in our favor. Okay, even if I look back, the correction was heavy from 537. It came back and then you find a good bounce back and the upside in RBL, right? So these are the kind of structure that we would look out for. So like, let's say the oil company Asian Paint, we can have a look at. Asian Paint is remaining weak after the results around this 1200 mark, and if you see now it has remained on the sideways. Kind of triangle formation has been formed, not symmetric, more or less on the downward side, I can say. So this is how Asian Paint looks like. It's going to remain range bound. So nothing fancy about it. But if oil tries to target higher, you can find Asian Paint going down. So if I see Asian Paint going down, it has good amount of support levels. The important support level is around this 1100 mark and even around this 1120 mark. Right? So there can be a downfall in Asian Paint type of oil, but a good correction will help us to look out for good buying as well on reversals. So the important point that I would look out for Asian Paint is 1042. This is where multiple times it has basically found reversals. Apart from that, even 1090 or 1100 also seems to be very strong, right? So look out for these kind of good stocks when they correct. They give you ample opportunity to buy, right? So that's it for the day, and the range remains to be the same and sideways, as we can see from both Nifty and Bank Nifty chart. Fine. So we'll connect tomorrow again and we try to decode the December part. But all I would now focus is three events of December and how our Nifty can pan out. So this was our first assumption or scenario building for Nifty. And then as things pan out next week, we'll try to strengthen with the levels which we have placed. Right? So have a good trading day and we'll connect tomorrow.